I knew from a really young age, as soon as I was introduced to music like TLC and Mary J. Blige, that was when I knew this was what I wanted to do. I grew up in Newcastle upon Tyne, which is northeast of England, and it was a little bit tough. We didn't have very much money, but I was very much loved and I had a good childhood. My family are really, really proud of the success that I've had so far, and it's all a bit alien to them. I think they find it all a bit strange and a bit funny at times, but yeah, they're very, very proud of what I've achieved. Fight for This Love was one of those songs that as soon as I heard it, I found myself getting excited. I wanted to listen to it again. I wanted to sing along to it. I couldn't get it out of my mind. I would describe Fight for This Love as urban pop, exciting, new sounds on there. I love the violins. I find it a really exciting sound and fresh. We gotta into the studio to record Fight for This Love, nobody made me aware that Wayne Wilkins and Steve Kipler had already written Sweet Dreams for Beyoncé. So I just toddle into this studio thinking, yeah, I'm going to record this great song. And they go, yeah, so when we did Sweet Dreams, and I'm thinking to myself, please tell me that's not the Beyoncé track. And when I knew that, I found myself under really quite a lot of pressure because it's Beyoncé. She's one of my idols, but, you know, it's different artists, different songs, and it was actually a really big learning lesson for me because they didn't want it to be like Beyoncé, they wanted it to be like me, and now I find myself finding it a little bit easier to work with producers that have worked with such fantastic artists already. Whenever you feel like we're growing apart, there's just no bad. The inspiration for the video, I wanted to make it a performance video because first and foremost is I love to entertain. So I wanted to make it a performance video. And the guy I worked with had already done some fantastic videos, so that was really exciting for me. And then I worked with the choreographer and the stylist to do the rest, and it just came out how I wanted it. Strong, woman empowering, and fun and entertaining, I hope. I knew people would connect with it like I did. So it was scary. Anything that was going to be the first single was going to be scary, but it felt like the right choice and it was proven to be, so I'm very happy about that. I think the secret to Girls Aloud success has been the fact that as a five, we really gel, and that is so important. To have longevity in this industry is really, really tough. So if you didn't have each other, there's a problem to start with. It's a team effort, and we've been very, very lucky to have each other. The future, hopefully, for Girls Aloud holds more of what we've already achieved, which is more success and a grown-up Girls Aloud, a woman's Aloud, let's say. That's hopefully the future. Being a solo artist has really made me re-energised and re-inspired and excited again, and especially the fact that I'm going to be entering different territories where I'm unknown. It's like starting from the beginning all over again. So to be playing in places like Asia, Europe, Australia, it's just really exciting and really surreal at the minute. I met a guy at the club. Favourite song I've written, I would say, is three words. It's very euphoric and very positive and uplifting, and it just makes you feel good to have the opportunity to be able to write with somebody so amazing as well I am. was just like a new feeling for me and something I love to do, whether I'm good at it or bad at it. I just enjoy it. Love of my life. Girls Aloud did a programme called Passions of Girls Aloud, where we embarked on different passions we had outside of Girls Aloud. Mine was street dancing initially, and I was only supposed to dance in will.i.am's video for his solo record at the time with a track called Heartbreaker. And he asked, would I be prepared to lay down some vocals? And it just seemed the natural thing to do. And we hit it off straight away, right from then. I remember watching an interview where Will was asked who he would like to collaborate with in Britain, and he said you two and Cheryl Cole, which I did chuckle to myself at. I felt really sweet. will.i.am definitely a massive influence on my album, that's without a shadow of a doubt, and a massive influence on the fact that I ever went solo in the first place. As a person, will.i.am is a real sweetheart. He's from a similar background to me, we connect on that level. I find him really intriguing. And he's a musical genius. Will loves to go to a club, and he'll tell you that the first time we ever met was in a club. We get to hang out, and I do love that part of it as well, because you get to socialise. Spending time in the studio is very intense. I love that as well. Each song on the album is something I've chosen because I connect with it. And I love the music, I love the production. And I think you just get to learn a little bit more about me as a person. I hope from three words I can achieve the sound that I would achieve personally. I would hope that people would enjoy the music I'd written lyrics to. And just that I give people enjoyment and I make people feel about my album, how people make me feel about their music. It's just an amazing feeling, and to hear it back and to hear that other people like it, especially if somebody picks out a song as their favourite from the album that you've written, it's just a buzz. Reservations about doing X Factor initially because I hate being judged and nobody likes being judged, and I didn't like having that title. Then I realised that actually I could really help these people achieve their goals and their dreams, and that's something I've achieved, and if I hadn't been given that opportunity, I wouldn't have. So I kind of took a step back and thought, actually, on the positive side, this is a really amazing thing. Recording Parachute was a really spontaneous thing for me, because I heard the song, loved it as soon as I heard it, could see myself doing the video as soon as I heard it. I was with a guy called Science, who's a young producer, and we were recording actually another song, and I just got the feeling that he was right for Parachute, and I rang up my A&R guy there and then and said, could we please record Parachute with Science? And this was like 1 o'clock in the morning, but I just knew it was right, and I knew he would do an amazing production on it, so I just recorded it there and then, and I think I was right. I think my instincts were good. My favourite memory from recording the album would probably be Fight For This Love. I just love doing what I do. I've loved recording this album, and I can only hope that people love listening to it as much as I love doing it. All I can hope for is that the next 2 years are as exciting and as fun as the last two have been.